Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Armin, and today I want to teach you the second part of the noise barrier tutorial. In the previous video, I showed you how to model a rigid wall. Today, I want to take it further and demonstrate how to model a flexible barrier. This example involves multiphysics, and it helps you learn about acoustic structure interaction. I encourage you to watch this video throughout to get the most out of it. Let's get started. This is part 1 model. As you see, I have removed the barrier from the domain because it was rigid. Now I want to apply solid mechanics physics to the barrier. So I will go to geometry and disable or delete the difference one. Here we can see the small barrier. I would like to have a better view of the barrier, so I will go to parameters 1 and enter 1 for Y0. After all, I will click on Build All and check out the geometry. Everything is okay. Geometry consists of two domains, environment and barrier. We have to deselect the barrier from the pressure acoustic domain. As you see, domain 2 is the barrier, so I will deselect it. Now we have an acoustic domain. Material must be defined correctly, but I leave it now and add a solid mechanics physics. I need solid mechanics physics, so I will go to the Physics tab and click on Add Physics. From the Add Physics window on the right, I will select Solid Mechanics. We need to deselect domain 1 because it is the acoustics domain. We can see that domain 1 is pressure acoustics, while domain 2 is solid mechanics. Here we have to define proper materials for two physics. Also, we can see the desired material properties in material contents. I need air for the acoustics domain, so I will deselect domain 2. Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio have been removed from material contents because they are used in solid mechanics. This warning reminds us to specify a material for domain 2. I will choose brick for the barrier and select the material in this way. We can find many popular materials in the built-in section. I have to define brick for domain 2. Okay, the materials are correctly defined. As you see, all of the material properties have a blue tick. Air is chosen for domain 1, which is also used in pressure acoustics physics. Domain 2 is brick and used for solid mechanics. It's time to generate mesh. There are two physics in physics controlled mesh. I don't change the default option and click on Build All. Two domains are meshed. Two physics must be coupled. Therefore, I will right click on Multiphysics and select Acoustic Structure Boundary. There are three interfaces between two physics. Also, we can select all boundaries for simplicity. You can see that the result is the same. As you see, acoustic structure boundary is added in mesh. It's better to click on Build All again. The barrier requires boundary conditions. I will fix the bottom using a fixed constraint. Okay, let's review the physics again. The boundary condition for solid mechanics seems correct, but I need to double-check the pressure acoustics. Also, I have selected domain 1 and set point 1 as the sound source. We have already reviewed multiphysics. I will keep the parametric sweep settings. Model is ready. It's time to click on compute. The solution is completed. You can see the acoustic pressure and the sound pressure level as in part 1. I want to see the barrier displacement, so I will create a 2D plot and add a surface. I will click on the Replace Expression icon and select Displacement Magnitude from Solid Mechanics Physics. This plot shows the displacement of the barrier. I want to see the deformation of the barrier, so I will right-click on Surface 1 and select Deformation. You can see the barrier displacement. By switching the dataset to the parametric sweep, results will appear with respect to frequency and height. We can change the unit from meters to millimeters from here. I want to see the stress plot, so I will add a 2D graph. Also, I need a surface. In expression, I will select von Mises stress from Solid Mechanics Physics. Alright, this is the stress graph. I need to add the deformation as I did earlier. By checking this option, you can see the maximum and minimum stress. Perfectly matched layer is another way to model free field space. It converts a part of the domain to a high absorption zone. I need to add layers around the air domain and define a perfectly matched layer for them. I think 0.3 meters is enough. In this example, I will take the top, right, and left layers. Finally, I will click on Build Selected or Build All. We can find the perfectly matched layer by right-clicking on Definitions. I will select layers from the graphics window. Then, we can go back to the perfectly matched boundary and deselect common boundaries with PML. The bottom of the domain is a perfectly matched boundary, and the top and around is PML. We can proceed to the mesh and click on the Build All icon. The mesh type has changed in the PML domain, and this is normal. Everything is okay, and I'm going to click on Compute. The results are visible in the graphics window. We can change the parameters and see the results. It's better to hide the perfectly matched layer. Therefore, I will go to Selection in the Settings window and choose Domain 3. I will tick the checkbox to hide the wireframe of the PML domain. A better show is presented now. We can apply this process to the sound pressure level graph. Diffraction can be seen in this area. The part 2 has ended. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like. Thank you.